satisfy the Laplace transform of this f of t equal e to the negative t psi t. By the definition, the Laplace transform of f of t is equal to the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative st f of t times dt. So whatever f of t is, you just plug it into this one. So I have the integral from 0 to infinity e to the negative st times e to the negative t psi t dt. So we have the same base, add the exponent together, which gives me e to the negative st minus t times psi t dt. Okay, so we have the an improper integral. So we have to take the limit as w goes to infinity of the integral from 0 to w. You can use whatever letter here you like as long as it's different from this t here. So for this one, I'm going to factor out the negative t. So we have e to the negative t. And in parentheses, I have s plus 1. Okay, so negative s times t minus t times psi t dt. So to integrate this, we are going to integrate it by part. Let u equal e to the negative s plus 1 t. Then du equals negative s plus 1 e to the negative s plus 1 t dt. Dv equals psi t dt. Then v equals negative cosine t. Then this becomes negative e to the negative s plus 1 t cosine t minus minus minus. So we have negative integral from 0 to w s plus 1 e to the negative s plus 1 times t cosine t dt. Okay, so we have the integral again. So we have to take another integral, do the same thing. So again, let u, okay, I ran out of space here, so let me do it down here. Let u equal s plus 1 e to the negative s plus 1 times t. Actually, I need to let it equal negative, so I carry the negative as well. Then du equals s plus 1 squared e to the negative s plus 1 t. Okay, so ring down the exponent, subtract the exponent, ring down the exponent. So we have negative, negative becomes positive, and then s plus 1 squared. Dv equals cosine t dt. Then v equals psi t. Then this becomes the limit as w goes to infinity, negative e to the negative s plus 1 t cosine t minus s plus 1 e to the negative s plus 1 t psi t minus the integral from 0 to w s plus 1 squared e to the negative s plus 1 t psi t dt. Oh, I forgot dt here. Okay. Right? Then we still have the integral. Then if I were you, I would integrate this again. But if you notice, if you integrated this again, you would get back to cosine. And then you would have another integral, and then you would integrate it, then you would get sine. So just go back and forth between sine and cosine. You wouldn't get rid of the integral. So after taking the integral twice, you will notice that. So this is what we started with. This one. Over here. So this is what we started with, and this is what we had after taking two integrals, right? So you notice we have this, and down here we have this, so they are the same. So dealing with something like this, you wouldn't get rid of the integral if you just keep integrating it. So after a couple of integrals, you will get back to this one. So I'm gonna do it this way. To get rid of the integral. So you have this, no, it's not this one. So you have this equals this, and this equals this. So now we have this one, so I'm going to rewrite it. Limit as w goes to infinity of this one. And so you have this equals this, and we have this and this, something in common. Excuse me. So I'm going to move this to the other side, which gives me positive integral from 0 to w, s plus 1 squared e to the negative s plus 1 times t psi t dt equals the limit of this one Oh, I ran out of space here. Okay. So on this side, I'm gonna factor out this. Okay, so I have the limit as w goes to infinity 1 plus s plus 1 squared times the integral from 0 to w e to the negative s plus 1 t psi t dt is equal to the limit as w goes to infinity. So for this one, I'm going to factor out negative e to the negative s plus 1 t. So factor it out, I have left in parentheses cosine t plus s plus 1 psi t. Okay? So for this one, you treat this as a constant because we integrate with respect to t, so the other variable is just constant. So the rule is that, so the property that we have, the property that the constant, we can pull out the limit, we can pull out and put it, pull out and in the limit. So I will divide both sides by 1 plus s plus 1 squared to get rid of this one, to divide this on this side. And on this side, we'll get rid of this. Then I have the limit as w goes to infinity of the integral from 0 to w e to the negative s plus 1 t psi t dt, which is what we want up here, right? And that is equal to this one, and we evaluate from 0 to w. So evaluating this, plugging w, I have limit as w goes to infinity of this, plugging w into this one, we have negative e to the negative s plus 1 times w cosine w plus s plus 1 psi w all over 1 plus s plus 1 squared minus, which becomes positive. Plug in 0, we have 1 cosine of 0, which is 1, psi of 0 is 0, over 1 plus s plus 1 squared. Now remember that the definition said that for the Laplace transform to exist, its value has to converge. So this goes to a number, so we're good. But for this one, as w goes to positive infinity, we wouldn't know what happened with this. And to make this converge, the exponent has to go to negative infinity. Why? Because the limit of e to the negative infinity is 0. So the exponent has to go to negative infinity, and this happens when s is greater than negative 1. Right? So when s is greater than negative 1, s plus 1 is positive, so this becomes negative, and then positive infinity, so negative infinity, the limit of e to the negative infinity is 0, then this converges. Then our final answer is equal to 1 over 1 plus s plus 1 squared for all s greater than negative 1. So this is your final answer. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.